to my channel Gemini on Mission. I'm Sakshi Pandit and this is an immediate help for final year students preparing for the graduation studies, which is in the next 10 days. These are the 10 study hacks that you need to know today. So do watch till the end. Believe me, even I'm using this and I'm in my graduating years. So let's face it together. Stop debating and start focusing, because we do not really have time to debate with ourselves, our mind, or even our friends to understand whether we should really have exams or not. It's finally happening. So let's focus on the plan of action. A few tips for you to remember before you really dive in with the studies, because this engine hasn't really focused or even paid attention to so much of matter for the previous months, but it's time to kickstart it. So tip number one in this particular section: create a work environment or a study environment that motivates you to study. A corner or a study table that really helps you to fuel in your engine. Do not just lie on your bed or, you know, sit in a corner or a place that really demotivates you or makes you feel lazy. And now that your study environment is created, keep only those books that you're studying for that particular time. Rest all distractions aside. Because keeping and piling up books, even notes or anything, will just make you go more mad, which you really don't want to. 3, if you're studying from a laptop, well and good. If you're studying from a phone, suggesting you to switch off the notifications button, because any message will really get you distracted, which you do not want, because every minute counts. Study pattern, a blueprint. Remember, a goal without a plan, it's just incomplete. So sit with yourself, spend some few minutes and understand which subjects to really start with. You might wonder that we have so many subjects, few are easy, few are hard. What do we really begin with? Now, there are two ways. Either you go with the reverse chronological order, that is, the subjects that are at the end of your timetable of your final year exams, you start with them, or else you start with the subjects that are hard. Now, according to our professors, imagine you are given a dish where you have your favorite items and there are a few items that you really do not like. Which one will you eat first? The things that you do not like, and then keep the delicious items at the end. Similarly, you can finish the hard subjects first and then the easy ones later. So hard subjects are those that require a little more brainstorming, more notes taking and a little tricky, and easy ones are those that require just scanning and just remembering the facts and figures. So according to your grasping capacity, whichever is easy for you, comfortable for you, pick them first. Focus, focus, focus. But that doesn't mean that you study 24/7, because that will just tire your brain and it will not support you. So are you a morning person? Can you wake up in the morning and study? Or an afternoon person or an evening person, decide a suitable time and take your books and study. Here there are two ways. One, do self-study, but yes, do not just stick to one source, that is the text or your notes or the PDFs. Sometimes there are a few topics that require some understanding and are not going in our brains despite reading it once and twice. So switch to YouTube videos, check on Google for articles and features, and I'm sure you will enjoy studying. 2, you either do group studies, but there is a drawback. Sometimes we end up gossiping and really missing our friends that we forget that we are here for studying. So prepare an agenda with your friends. Let your friends prepare a module or a topic and then discuss. And I'm sure this is going to be the most fun, amazing, fastest and easiest method. While so many students are stressing on the paper pattern, well, it's an advantage. This time it's MCQs. So you do not really have to mug up chapters or texts or stress on the quality, on the quantity, or how much will you write for so and so marks, but you just have to choose the right answer. One quick tip for studies: while starting your day, understand which subjects or chapters or notes that you want to go through. Keep your aim clear and set your alarm, grab your book, read loudly and fast. I know it sounds funny, but it really helps. If there are a few sentences that you're not understanding, just take a break. Do something that you love and get back to studies. but do not leave the track. And if there are topics that you're not really able to understand, switch to some other sources. Either read articles, features, or YouTube channels. It's about having fun and understanding the topics. You might be thinking of multiple ways to help yourself during the exam, but do not challenge the technology. A lot of institutions are coming up with apps and softwares that are going to keep a minute eye on you while you give your exams. I know it's going to be scary, but it's better not to be sorry. So prepare yourself, you still have time. Don't stress yourself, but believe in your capacity. Do not focus on how much others have prepared, because this is our last exam, not of our life, but of our graduation. I'm sure you want to give your best shot. Don't think of how well you performed in the previous semesters. This is the current one and you have to give your best. Also, the most important point. Well, while following all these 9 steps, keep a track of your timetable, exam timetable, because sometimes it becomes complex and confusing. Also, this time you do not have to worry about your eraser, pen or pencil, but your technologies. So make sure you charge them, make sure your network is working, and be presentable. Such a cool thing, right? For the very first time, we can enter the hall without really being there and wearing our pajamas. But it is only going to make you feel lazy and sleepy. So be presentable, be charged up, and all the best.